Hey there, Lindsay here, the Frugal Crafter, and it is Sketchbook Sunday. Today I thought it'd be fun to do some summery fruit since it still is very much wintry here in Maine. I started off sketching in my sketchbook with just a regular old number 2 mechanical pencil, and I'm getting some basic shapes down for my fruit. So I've got these kind of rounded triangles for the strawberries and some circles overlapping for the lemon slices. I just want to put a little bit of detail in there for like the lemon wedges, and I'm erasing lines I don't need. Like where the circles overlap each other, I just erase the portion of the circle from the underlapping fruit so that I don't have those to worry about. And I'm just sketching in some squashed circles for the blueberries. I like to go in once I've decided that I have the lines correct, I'll go in and just color a little bit darker or trace over my lines a little bit more darkly so that I can see the detail a little bit better and that I won't wash it away when I go to paint it. Some little details I'm putting in would be like the spokes of the segments of the lemon and kind of rounding them at the top so they have that nice realistic look. And that's pretty much it. I also want to mention that I've got a head cold, so I probably sound funny, and I'm wearing some new headphones, and the earbuds just like randomly fall out of my ear, so if you hear a weird click or drop, that's what that is. I'm going to begin by putting in a very soft background wash, just for some kind of like kind of local gray, just like a little soft local shadow. So I wet the area first and quickly went in with my very watery gray that I made with a mixture of ultramarine blue and burnt sienna. Now this is a sketchbook, it's not a watercolor pad, so you do have to work a little bit quicker if you're trying to do a wet into wet wash, otherwise the paper just dries too quickly. This is a very nice sketchbook, it's a Fabriano Venice book, it's the same one I use for all my Sketchbook Sunday videos. It handles watercolor very well, but it is still, more of a sketch weight paper. So I have put in lemon yellow in one of the lemon slices, and then I dripped in some gamboge, which is a warmer yellow, and then I just added just a little touch of green to my brush, olive green. It was left over from yesterday's painting or Friday's painting, and I just kind of touched that in some places where I wanted a little bit of a shadow, because I knew if I touch the green in there, it's not going to give me a dull shadow. It's still going to be vibrant and a little bit darker and still look fresh. If I had used purple to like neutralize it that way with its opposite, it would look kind of like rotted, you know, it would just lose that freshness. So when you are working with fruit or flowers and you need to make a shadow for them, instead of using the opposite color of the color wheel to mix in to make your neutralized color, use a color friend. So if it's yellow, you could use a little green. If it's red, you could use purple for a shadow. It just gives you a much fresher look. Now you can neutralize that a little bit more, with the opposite color, but generally when you're overlapping those colors, you do get a pretty normal, fresh looking dark. For the blueberries, I have been kind of jumping around and working on a couple at a time. I mixed some ultramarine blue and burnt sienna to kind of gray it down a bit, and some carmine red so that I would get some different shades of violet. I'm also using some phthalo blue here and there because blueberries can have greenish tints, they can have violet tints. You have a variety of different colors to work within when you're doing blueberries. The thing with blueberries, it really gives it the nice natural look, is that it's got kind of like this waxy film on it, and if you can achieve that by leaving some lighter areas, that will go a long way to make it look realistic. Basically, my goal here in this first layer of the painting is just to get some basic colors down, but if I can do a couple colors in each pass, it really saves me some work down the line. So for the strawberries, for the darkest color, I'm using crimson, and I think it's Crimson Lake, which is a discontinued color from Winsor & Newton, and then I'm using some bright red, which is a Sennelier color, and some gamboge, which is also the Sennelier version, and letting the colors kind of mix and mingle together so I have a nice full looking color on my painting. I'm using a combination of brushes today. I'm using some of my new Menta from Royal Inline Nickel that I picked up at A. Seymour a couple weeks ago. But since I only picked up a couple larger brushes in that line, I'm going to my Creative Mark Mimics for these smaller brushes like I'm using here for the strawberry. So use what you have, whatever gets the job done. Now I have gone back to some of that really light mixed gray, which is the burnt sienna and ultramarine, and I'm just kind of putting in a little bit of tone onto the lemon rind. So you've got the flesh of the fruit, then you've got the rind, then you've got the outer rind, so the white, I guess, would be like the pith. You want to make those distinct different passages of color. That's going to help give you that detail and realism that you're going to want for your sketch. But again, remember, it is a sketch. It is meant to be recording information fairly quickly but accurately. So don't feel like you have to put in tons and tons of detail, but make every brush stroke count, make every layer count, and make sure everything you're doing is kind of building on the image. Now with some stronger yellow, I went in and did some little streaks. When you do those streaks in the lemon wedges, you want to make sure they're going from the center of the lemon to the outside of the lemon, kind of like daisy petals off of a daisy. They should be going around kind of like, or points of a compass kind of coming off like that. I decided that my shadow needed to be a little bit darker, so I went in with a another glaze of color. And when I glaze over, I generally put the color in and then I'll blend it out with a dry brush, or a damp brush rather, so that way I don't end up disturbing everything that's underneath there. I'm adding some yellow and some olive green into the stems on the, or the leaves on the strawberries there. I like to do two tones because it just makes it seem a little more lively and fresher, and it gives you a highlight and shadow all in one. And we can go in and put more shadows later on down the line. But again, if you can get a lot done while on your first layer, it just saves you a lot of time, and it often looks a lot fresher and more natural in the long run. The leaves on this strawberry are a little bit darker because you're not seeing that center stem area that you can see on the other two strawberries because of the way they're turned. So just pay attention to your reference and keep looking back and forth as you sketch to make sure you are putting down that information accurately. So to get the waxy film on the blueberries, it's quite easy. So what I'm doing is going down and putting another layer on. So that first layer is kind of the lightest layer that we're going to have. And then what I'm doing is I'm taking my little brush and I'm picking up the watery grayish blue violet paint and just kind of doing these little tiny crisscross X strokes. So I'll do like a little outline and I'll crisscross, crisscross, crisscross over that. And I start in the shadowy area and just kind of build my little crisscrosses up towards a highlight. But I let my brush kind of run out of paint as I'm doing that. So it gives you that frosted look, and it just kind of gets lighter naturally as it comes up to the front of the berry, like where the light would be hitting it, which is kind of like an overhead, very soft overhead still life type of lighting. And you just kind of work your way around. If you notice something is a little bit darker, use your mix that has more burnt sienna and ultramarine blue. If you notice that it's a little bit fresher, you can use a mix that has a little bit more phthalo blue in it. Very subtle little differences, but the more you sketch in your sketchbook, the more you try to accurately create things, the more you'll be able to notice those subtle color undertones and be able to adjust for them. This is a really nice and useful texturing technique because you may find that there are other things that you want to paint that would have the very similar waxy film to it, like other fruits such as grapes, or even if you were doing like an icy window or an icy pond, you might want to be able to render those just kind of soft frosted textures. So practice it. And this is a really fun project and fun still life to do this with because each of the little blueberries are kind of small. So you don't have to get, you know, too overwhelmed. You can do a couple, then work on another part of your picture, come back, do a couple more, work on another part of your picture. So it's a much less daunting when you have kind of a confined space to try a new technique on. Now you'll notice that the blueberries have either, they have a stem on one side and a little dot on the opposite side. And you're not going to see it on every berry because of the way that they're turned, but you want to make sure that a couple of your berries have the kind of iconic like crisscross stem, and some have a little dimple, just, you know, to give it a little interest to make it look a little more unique. Now with that grayish color that I mixed, I can go in, add a smidgen of green to it just to make it look a little bit more neutral to the lemon, and I can add a few little streaks of that shadow. Now these streaks, I want you to think of like when you take a piece of citrus and you see all these kind of like juice packets, you know how they have all these tiny little juice globules in there in any slice of citrus, that line that you're putting in there would kind of be like along the edge of one of those little juice packets. That's just the best way I can think of describing it. I'm sure they probably have a name, but that's as close as I'm going to come to describing it, I guess. And that just helps you have that dimension and that jewel-like quality of the fruit. Now for the shadow on the strawberries, what I'm doing here is I've mixed the ultramarine blue and the Crimson Lake, and I'm getting this nice dark color, and I'm just kind of tapping it in because I don't want a smooth texture. I want it to look kind of like the pits where the seeds are. So instead of just painting on smooth, I'm dabbing it on so that I get kind of like little little strawberry seed pits, and I get that texture that's not smooth on the outside of the strawberry. And it just helps give it not only the shadow that it needs for the form, but also the texture of the fruit. So it's important to use a kind of an appropriately sized brush for that and dab it to bring up that texture. And you can also add shadows under any of the little strawberry leaves. Now I have switched over to some acrylic paint pens. I got this set for Christmas. It is so useful and fun. They're just super fine tip, almost like a gel pen, but they have acrylic paint in them, and you can actually take them apart and refill them, even though the company doesn't say you can do that, but you totally can do that. So I'm using that for my brightest highlights on the strawberries. You could use a gel pen for that if you wanted to. And I was also using it on the lemon wedges, and you'll see that again in a second. When you do the highlights on the strawberries flesh, what you're doing is you're catching the brightest highlights, like the if you have a dab that's like a shadow on the pit of a seed hollow, generally the light would be above the seed hollow. You're not painting the seeds, you're just doing a little glints of reflection on there. Now I am lightening up the center of the lemon wedges where you've got that kind of white pith, and then I'm also pulling some of that white down through the kind of segments between each of the chunks of the juicy lemon globules. I don't know how to explain it, but I think you know what I mean. And I'm also going in and adding some to the blueberries, which had a pretty good frosty look anyway, but I figured out why not. I've got the pen out, so I'm just kind of dabbing on a little, scribbling on a little bit, then smudging it with my finger or tapping it with my finger to get rid of any really sharp lines. I just want it to look very soft and frosty. And then I was doing another layer over the kind of membranes on the lemon just to brighten them up and make them a little more opaque. I'm not sure if these acrylic paint pens are as opaque as a gel pen. Sometimes it seems they are, and then other times I feel like they almost mix in with what's underneath. So I'm not 100% sure, but I love the fact that I can refill it, and they don't seem to clog up like a gel pen will if you don't use it for a long time. So I think that's a really useful trade-off. The pack of fine tip pens that I had, the acrylic paint pens, had a great yellow and red, and we're going to use this as well. So I'm using this yellow one for accenting the rind, accenting the colors inside the lemon slices, redefining those spooky lines that I mentioned before, because they're just so bright. These acrylic paint pens are really fantastic, and they're not very expensive either. You just want to make sure you'll get the extra fine ones if you want that really fine detail. Now, strawberry seeds are yellow, so I am actually dotting in some of those yellow seeds here. But if they end up being too bright, you can always glaze over with watercolors. For a small area like this, it'll tone it down just fine. So you can go ahead and add the yellow any place you think it will help. And then I'm going in and adding a little bit more shadow to the white rind of the lemon, because it just seemed a little too bright. So it's that same mix, that gray mix of ultramarine and burnt sienna. And I'm also bringing some of that where the lemons overlap each other, just kind of on the underneath lemon, just to kind of help get a little bit more dimension there. As I proceeded through this painting, I realized that I needed some darker shadows, so I'm just taking some of that light mixed gray and going in and applying them between the blueberries, also in some of the sections of the lemon, to just get a little bit of shadow, because lemon slices, they'd be translucent, you would see some shadows underneath, and I just wanted to make sure that it had that dimension. I used some of my mixed purple to refine the shadows a bit in the strawberries and tone down any highlights that I thought were too bright. And then I decided to go back in and do some glazing over the blueberries using some watered down phthalo blue. That just helps give it a little bit more freshness that I might have lost a bit with the white paint pen. Ever since I started keeping my colored pencils in jars next to my desk, I've noticed that I reach for them a lot more often because it's so easy. And so I grabbed a kind of a violet blue pencil here to go through and add a little bit more of a purpler bias on some of the blueberries. And then taking indigo, I'm just going in and refining the stems on some of them and the like bottom contour of them, just to give them a little bit more weight and make their shadows look a little bit more prominent. As you work through your painting and you start to get more of the page filled, you want to do less with every pass through that you do. So here with this really fresh bright red color. I am just hitting the areas that I think need a little bit of boost in color, but I'm not coloring over the whole thing. Every layer you do should be a little bit less than the previous layer, because you want the other layers to show through, and you don't want to just charge in and cover up your work. In fact, it's not a bad idea to take a break when you get done one layer. Like if you do the watercolor portion and you're not sure if you want to proceed on with any other media, if you take a break and come back, you'll be able to see that that painting with fresh eyes. You're going to see it very truthfully, whereas if you charge through and force yourself to progress through a picture all in one sitting, you can make some hasty decisions that you're going to regret later on. I actually did take a little break before I came in with the colored pencils because I had to pick up my daughter from a friend's house, so it was a nice natural break, and I'm glad I did. And I did decide I wanted to do more to it, but you know, sometimes you don't, and it's nice if you can give yourself that permission to just step away from it for a bit. I wish my voice sounded better today. I hope it hasn't been too annoying to listen to. I've got my red Posca pen here, and I'm just going in and putting in some highlights and also signing my name. I want to thank you for watching this. If you enjoyed it, please give me a thumbs up and let me know what you're working on in your sketchbook today in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Until next time, happy crafting.